Please subscribe math.com for any query, comment or email. Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss few examples that how you can solve a linear equations involving radicals, but there will be multiple variables and constants. Okay. In our previous lecture, we have seen that there was only one variable in the given equation. So these examples will be quite a little bit complex so that you can understand how you can solve the complex equations involving variables and constants. So the example here is cube root of 2x plus 3 equals to the cube root of x minus 2. So this is the equation, as it is seen from here that the variable x is on both sides of the equation. Now how you can solve such equations? Let's solve it out. You can solve these by, as we have already seen in our previous lecture, that whenever you came across the radical sign, you have to solve the radical sign by taking the value of the index of the radical sign and by raising each side to the power equal to the index of the radical sign. So here we have a cube root and the index is 3. So what we will do taking cube on both sides. It will be like 2x plus 3, as cube root is equals to 1 by 3 and the cube is 3. Okay, then on the other side is x minus 2, cube root is equals to 1 by 3 and the 3 and the cube is 3. So it will be cancelled out and the equations came out 2x plus 3 equals to x minus 2. Now it can be easily solved as 2x minus x plus 3 equals to x minus 2. What we have done? We have subtracted x on both sides. As according to the rule of math, if you add on one side, you should add on another side also. And if you subtract on one side, then you have to subtract from another side as well. Okay. So it will become as like this. So 2x minus x is x, x plus 3 is equals to minus 2. Now you have to free up the x. Okay, so you have to free up the x. So we have to subtract 3 on both sides to free up the x. So x plus 3 minus 3 equals to minus 2 minus 3. So what we will get here? We have got x is equals to minus 5. Now this is the solution of the given equation. Okay. Now this is exactly the same way we have already seen in our previous lecture. How you can solve the linear equations with radicals. But a little bit difference is here that we have came across the multiple variables here. So our situation has changed. Now let's check out its solution, whether it is right or not. As it is necessary to check, as sometimes we also came across some extraneous rules that are that means we got multiple rules and we have to select only those that satisfy the given condition. So the equation was cube root of 2x plus 3 equals to cube root of x minus. Okay. Now what you have to do, putting what is the value of x? X is equals to minus 5, equation 1. And what is the equation 1? This is equation 1. Okay. We will put as cube root of 2 into minus 5 plus 3 equals to cube root of minus 5 minus 2. Okay. Then it will be minus 10 plus 3 equals to cube root of minus 7. And then cube root of minus 7 equals to cube root of minus 7. So left hand side is equals to right hand side. So now we can say without any hesitation that x is equals to minus 5 is the solution of the given equation. So this is how we can solve the equations involving radicals with multiple variables and constants. Okay, let's have one more example, as examples made your concepts clear. Example 2 is x plus 1 divided by 2x plus 5 is equals to 2, where x is not equal to minus 5 by 2. They have put this condition of x is equals to minus 5, x is not equal to minus 5 by 2, because if you put the value of x is equals to minus 5 by 2, the expression becomes undefined. So that means that the given equation has no solution. Okay, so let's solve it out as x plus 1 over 2x plus 5 is equals to 2. Okay, so what we have to do? We have to raise each side to the power equal to the index of the radical. Here the index is 2, so we can take square on both sides. So it will be as x plus 1 over 2x plus 5 equals to 2 square. Here 2 into 1 by 2. As the radical is 1 by 2 and as it's a square root, so 1 by 2 multiplied by the square that we have taken. So it will become x plus 1 over 2x plus 5 equals to 4. Okay. So what we have to do, we have to multiply 2x plus 5 on both sides. So x plus 1 into 2x plus 5 over 2x plus 5 is equals to 4 into 2x plus 5. So what it will be then cancelled out, and we will get x plus 1 equals to 4 into 2x plus 5. Solve it out as x plus 1 equals to 8x plus 20. Okay, so we'll combine the like terms by adding or subtracting as 8x minus x and 1 minus 20. It will be 7x equals to minus 19. X is equals to minus 19 by 7. So this is the solution of the given equation. Let's check it out whether it is right or not by putting back the values in this equation. Okay, so here is the check where we will put back the values of value x in the original equation. The equation was the square root of x plus 1 over 2x plus 5 is equals to 2. Okay, so we have to putting x is equals to minus 19 by 7 in equation 1, and this is the equation 1. What we will get? We will get right as x is minus 19 by 7 plus 1 divided by 2 into minus 19 by 7 plus 5 equals to 2. Then under root minus 19, we'll take the LCM, plus 7 divided by 7. Then again here we will take the LCM as minus 19 plus 1 divided by 7 of the numerator, and then in the denominator we'll do the same as 7. 19 into 2 is 30 minus 38 plus 35. We are taking the LCM equals to 2. Then under root minus 19 plus 1 is minus 19 plus 7 will be minus 12 by 7 divided by minus 3 by 7 equals to 2. Okay, the 7, 7 and minus minus cancelled out. Then under root 12 by 3 equals to 2. 3 4s are 12. It means under root 4 equals to 2. That is equals to 2 is equals to 2. This means that the value of x that we have found is the solution of the given equation. That is x equals to minus 19 by 7 is the solution of the equation. Okay. So this is how we can find the solution of the equations involving the radical equations and the multiple variables and constant. Hope so it will help you a lot. Thank you
for watching. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe our channel math.com for more updates. Thank you.